And they were both in the back corner.
Stupid.
Whoa.
So stupid.
Oh, that was a really funny clip from the stream yesterday. I've had some fun leaving the mics on it. I wish it was still kind of like, you know, BO2 days in terms of microphone quality and the amount of chatting that goes on. Because it's really not that talkative, it seems like. Oh, we're going all the way around here. Look at the people over here. Oh, they're going after my team? Okay, it's all right. I got your cover, guys. I got your revenge anyway. Not cover so much, sorry. Wasn't there quite... Hey! There's no fucking way. That is not an XMC. The second I shot it, it was like, this doesn't seem like it's going to work. There's the bomb. Well, we can just sit over here and look for him, I guess. He's got to come get the bomb. Anyways, I've been happy listening to people talk again. Although, like I said, I still wish the quality was top notch. It's fun hearing reactions. It's fun hearing freakouts. It's fun hearing rage moments. Ooh, this guy's trying. Dead Silence Awareness XMC. Is a suppressor. What the hell? Doesn't sound like it because the kill cam's broken with the gun, but you can see it on the gun. It has a suppressor. Don't... Okay, maybe you should as sometimes, but it's not good. Suppressors aren't good, typically. I wouldn't suggest you use it. I wish that, like, it was similar to Xbox, where you could talk in the game very easily, and you could very easily record responses from people, because that is the biggest weakness, I feel like, when it comes to... trying to have like a community interaction. Oh my god, he almost got killed. There were two in the fucking... I didn't see the other one. I saw one though. And he somehow missed a Marshall shot from a foot away. Bad kid in a corner. My team probably has it. 42, they got the bomb down. Hope one of them's watched flank. There you go, he's figuring it out. Nice. Boa sight too, weird. Ripper, Invis, that guy's dumb. He's not going to get that specialist ability, whatever, the heat, the flamethrower. These guys will get theirs, definitely. Two Rippers and an Invis. I'm an Invis. Free kill, one in bunker now. Jump up, you got him. This is Dead Silence Awareness guy. Care, what? Off to your right? Nope, he got killed anyway. Nice, alright. Team's stepping up, I like it. Few of them anyway, the other guys are kind of just having a rough start, it seems. Man, they are really trying. I got multiple people on my squad running Dead Silence Awareness classes. Oh, if I was against them, I'd be fucking mad at them. I'm mad they're even on my team, though. Get rid of awareness. Please don't have it in the next game. Please don't have it. There's no reason to have it. It doesn't benefit any player ever. Well, it benefits players if you're a fucking nerd and you camp and sound mode, but I mean, it doesn't benefit the game. Awareness is not something that adds to the game and makes it a better game. It makes it a worse game. Oh, protect me, HC car. Okay. I want stuff to be like, I don't know, I keep going back to BO2, I guess, for this video, but I just think BO2 is a really good game, and I can't, like I said, I can't play it because just Xbox 360 is so hacked, but if you look at a game that you want to replicate, what the fuck? Where'd he hit me from? Where was that? I see him even? That was stupid. If you look at a game that you want to replicate for a good Call of Duty experience, and I think professional players, MLG players, competitive players, and public match players are all going to agree, BO2 is the last really good game. There were some more in the past, but I would not say Ghost was a great game. I would not say Advanced Warfare was a great game. They're good, but I'm just saying great, really good. Not just meh, not just acceptable. Really good. BO2 had to have been it. BO2, at least on Xbox, had a great party chat system, had a great in-game chat system, easy to record. The maps were overall pretty damn nice. Oh, that's not good. That guy's gonna fuck me up. We're just gonna avoid that man right now. We're gonna go all the way around. We're gonna go to... Oh, no! Fucking camping him, motherfucker, dude. Of course he backs up and looks at his spawn. Why wouldn't he? Because so many people rush in this game. Like, you know, me. And that's it. That's the extent of it. No more people rush after that. Oh my god, don't let it happen to you. Oh my god, you are the worst fucking player I've ever seen, dude. Ever! You have a Dead Silence Awareness VMP and you're still 0-3. Holy shit, you're hot trash. Wow. I'm dumbfounded that that just happened. Embarrassing. And we got it on camera. But BO2 did a lot right. I would say the maps were pretty good. Some maps sucked. Every game has some shitty maps. There's no avoiding that. Not every map's gonna be great. Everyone has preference, but BO2 had overall pretty good map creation. It had a good chat system. It was easy to use, easy to record. It was balanced, very well balanced, I think, in terms of guns and perks. And that's something that they really struggle with in this game. More dead silence awareness. How many motherfuckers have this shit on? Holy Christ. Seriously. There's like 7 dudes running dead silence awareness this game. Good lord. Guys, relax a bit. It's not MLG championships, motherfuckers. We're just playing the game. And I'm working on dark matter on this gun too, because I don't have it on this one either. Ah, that's not a good call to do that. No way you were gonna win that, bro. I don't know what you were sitting there for. He's back in the spawn. Nice. You finally decided to leave your spawn with that VMP, huh? Let's see, this guy had an M8, didn't he? I need this to aim back in the spawn if I got someone even further back. My PPSH doesn't have a lot of range to it. I don't know where he is. I'm just gonna drop this now. I wanted that mainly to cover their spawn, but since they're not there now, I'm fine with the PPSH. I can close the gap between me and the enemies. I'm hoping World War II fills that gap, though. I'm hoping World War II can replicate BO2. And from what I've seen in the beta so far, it looks pretty good. We haven't had a big example like of maps. So, you know, those could be sketchy. Those could be kind of shittier, but we'll see shortly. I'm not going to charge that guy, actually. He has an XMC. A little bit stronger than my gun, close range. A little bit. But so far, World War II, I thought, was pretty good. The perk balance was pretty good. The classes is a little strange, but it didn't really seem to take away from the game. We're going to know more about that when Search and Destroy comes out. Because I feel in Respawn, you could probably get away with 2 or 3, maybe 4 different classes. In S&D, the sound horn might be a little too much. They might have to lessen the footsteps so the class with dead silence isn't too OP. Alright, what we're doing here is we're watching this line of sight. We're seeing if the water moves right there. If the water moves, there's a good chance he's in it. I didn't see it move. I think he's just camping to lose. Yep. Hey, you're camping to die and lose. Congrats. That's the way to play. Don't play the objective and then get beat down anyway. You know. Sure. If that's your style, go for it. I wouldn't suggest that, but you know. It's all on you. You take your own approach. But so far, I'm liking how World War II looks to BO2. I'm just hoping that they can try to replicate BO2 as much as they can with also, you know, keeping it an original game. I was trying to think about what I would want from a Call of Duty game, and I get asked a lot what my favorite game is. Annoying. BO2 is not my favorite game. MW2 is. And Modern Warfare 2 had its problems, but it was one of my favorite games. And I think that's probably in part due to the friends that I played with during that game. But I'd still like to see another BO2 made. And I think World War II has that potential. Based off of looking at the game, playing the game, seeing what's in it and what isn't in it, it looks pretty solid so far. I've been pessimistic about it, I admit. I'm not one to give them too much credit. And I've seen some shit that I've not liked. Like how they're going to have weapon variants. From what we know, they're not weapon variants that actually affect damage, range, fire rate, you know, shit like Advanced Warfare had. But it is a weapon variant that affects how the gun looks, which isn't a big deal. But, you know, I mean, we're still thinking, oh, they're going to add real weapons to the game. It's going to be like freaking MWR was, and I don't want that. Not as much, really. I would prefer if it was just aesthetic changes, things that make them look different. I'm not sure they'll be able to keep up with that, but we'll see. In either case, I wanted to make this video because I was trying to figure out where World War II or how World War II could become a fan favorite. And I think because of how old the game is in terms of like the setting in World War II, the best odds, the best chances it has is trying to replicate BO2's system. But thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you all next time.